Hey everyone, and welcome back to another Tuesday Tip, where in this video I'm going to be talking about a few specific functions within the Splice video editing app for iPhone. And before we get started, if you are here looking for a complete overview and tutorial on this app, I already have that video made, which I will link in the info card right here for you guys to click on, as well as in the description down below. This, like I said, is about a few specific functions within the app, but the complete overview and tutorial that I have goes over every single function of this app and shows you how to do it. So if you're interested, you know where to find it. And with that being said, the first function that I'm going to be talking about here is the one that I get the most questions about, and that is how to select a specific portion of a song to use within your project and how to pick where the song starts and ends specifically within the song. So to do this, let's pick a song from the audio library that Splice gives us. I'm going to pick Cheerful and pick this first song here, then push add. It does give you a preview beforehand. I'm just going to push add, and it's going to go into the project, as you can see, with this blue track right here that we can slide through with our finger. And to answer the question of how you select a specific portion of this song, you have to do so within the timeline here, and you can use the split function that shows up once you click on the audio. And now that the song's in our video project, you can see that the entirety of the song is here, so we have to select which portion of it we want to use in the video. And to do that, we're going to use the split function, which you can see is in the bottom row of icons. And all you have to do is find the part of the song that you want to be the beginning. Make sure that you touch the song, because if you touch off of it like I just did, it disappears, but all you have to do to bring it back up is press this white square with a music note in it, and it brings it back up. You can see that our split function is here. And just so you guys can experience this and see that we're putting a specific portion of the song in the beginning, let's push play from about the 12 second mark. Now we want to split it right here where she says, "I don't trust you." We're going to push split. It splits it into two different parts. And as you can see, these white squares show up at the beginning of every single piece of audio that you have in your project. Also, as you can see, it keeps the first portion of the song selected. And all we have to do to bring this part of the song that we want to the beginning is push delete on the first portion, then press this white square to bring up our selected portion of the song. Click and hold on the song, and you can feel some haptic feedback here depending upon your phone, and then we just drag it to the beginning. So keep doing that. You can also pinch to zoom in and out on your project so that it can make it easier to drag the song to the beginning. So we're going to touch and hold again and drag it all the way to the beginning. Now we're going to push play. There you go. And that was the exact moment that we pushed the split button. I've had a lot of comments saying that people have tried this and it didn't work. And I believe what was happening is that people were accidentally trimming the song back to the beginning, which, if you want to know how to trim audio and video within this app, that's another specific function I wanted to cover. In order to trim your audio, all you have to do is push and hold on that point where it will give you some haptic feedback, and then you drag back and forth anywhere you want it to go to extend or decrease the length of your audio. Then from here, in order to trim video, all you have to do is touch the video. It will highlight it in blue to where you can see that there's little white lines at the beginning and ends of our clip, and you do the exact same thing. Touch and hold on the beginning and end, but with the video, it turns yellow so we know that we're trimming it. And you can actually select a very specific point in the video because it gives you a preview with the preview window. I want to end it there. We can also do the exact same thing with the beginning by just touching and holding, waiting for it to turn yellow, then extending it or shortening it to select the specific starting point that we want for the clip. And as you can see, while we're dragging, it's changing the beginning point of the project as a whole, which is a neat little feature that they also threw in there. Another question I've received quite a few times is, why can't I put specific songs from my iTunes library into Splice? And the answer to that, directly from the developers of Splice itself, is that Sometimes there's confusion in which songs in your iTunes library actually come from Apple Music. If you have a song downloaded to be listened to offline from Apple Music, it will show up in your iTunes library, but because it's from your subscription to Apple Music and because you didn't buy it from iTunes directly, you can't use it within Splice. With that being said, let's show you guys that adding sound effects and editing those is exactly the same as editing your music. All you have to do is click and drag on the beginning or the end to trim it. You can also adjust the speed as well as the volume of sound effects, music, audio recordings, as well as the audio from your video directly within the app independently of each other. So as you can see, we can set this sound effect to be 30% volume. We can set the song and this portion of the song specifically to be 70% volume. Then we can select the other portion of the song, and as you can see, it's different, so we can change that independently of everything else, as well as the volume of our video tracks, and we can do that independently as well as fade in and out of them. Through the process of making this video, we've added a song, cut it in half, as well as added a sound effect. And that's a great illustration to show and tell you guys that there is no limit to the amount of audio elements that we can use within the audio track in Splice. We can add as many sound effects as we want, as many songs as we want, as many pieces of songs as we want. And all of these songs, sound effects, and audio recordings are non-destructively edited whenever we trim or split within Splice, which means that even though we split this song into two pieces, we can use the trim function to bring back the portion that we split off of it. And the same goes for the first part. We can trim and re-add the end part. Same goes for sound effects and audio recordings as well. Another question I've gotten on occasion is whether or not the music provided within the Splice app itself is royalty free. The answer to that directly from the developers of Splice itself is yes. These songs are royalty free, so it is safe to use them for monetization within your YouTube videos. And that's gonna wrap this one up. If you enjoyed the video, check out the playlist on screen right now for some more iPhone video editing app videos. And if you have any questions or comments, leave them in the comment section below, where I do my best to answer every single question to the best of my ability. And now that I'm in contact with the Splice developers directly, I can answer these questions even better for you guys. So with that being said, subscribe if you're new, and we'll catch you in the next one tomorrow. Thank you for watching. Goodbye.